Hello dear students, we have started the lesson sound, yes or no? In that we have learned the different types, different things in the sound, that is the characteristics of the sound, how the sound is produced. Then we have learned the sound is nothing but it is a form of the energy, and it is nothing but it is in the form of the wave. We have learned the what is exactly the waves and what are the terms required for the waves. Am I right? Then we have discussed in the last video about audible and inaudible sound. Am I right? Do you remember what is meant by the audible and inaudible? What is the frequency of the human being to be hear the sound? Can you tell me the range of the human audible sound? Yes, it is nothing but between the 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz. And if the sound is less than 20 hertz, then that sound is called as a infrasonic sound. Am I right? Then we have discussed the sound which is more than 20,000 hertz, it is called as a ultrasonic sound. Then in today's video we are going to discuss about the reflection of the sound. Now can you tell me what is meant by the reflection? Reflection, the word itself. Now for example, in the do you know light? Have you seen the light? Yes. Now see, when the light falls on a particular object, it reflects back. Am I right? It reflects back. Now see, if you will take for example, now see, if you will take here a box, in a box if you will take a clock, if you will keep a clock in a box and if you will put a lid on it, will we be able to hear the noise of this clock? No, the sound may get decrease. Am I right? Yes or no? Sound may get decrease because the sound is reflected here but it comes back again. Am I right? It does not allow to come out of the box. Am I right? So the sound, we are not able to hear it properly. But the thing is that it depends on the material used. It also depends on the material use. So in this we are going to learn about good and bad reflector of the sound. Now have you visited the cinema hall or auditorium? Have you seen the auditorium and the cinema hall? It is very large. Am I right? Cinema halls, then auditorium, they are very large. Am I right? And for example, now see, before going to this example, if you will enter in a empty room, if there is nothing, and if you will enter in a empty room, it means empty means what? Full empty. There is nothing inside that particular room. Then what you will hear? You will hear your sound. The sound is get reflected back. Am I right? Whatever you will speak, you will get again re-vibration of that sound. Am I right? Yes or no? So it is called as a good reflector. Now for an example, now we'll turn to this example. When you will go in auditorium and cinema halls, of the auditorium and the cinema hall is too large. Am I right? So the re-vibration of the sound can be possible. So to avoid this, see, if there is a re-vibration of the sound, we will not be able to hear the particular sound. Am I right? So in that, in cinema and auditorium, they have put some reflector, good absorber of the sound. For example, the carpet, yes, then ceiling, the which has been put, it is of good absorber of the sound. Are you getting? So there are the some things that we now when you are in empty hall, if you will put some tables, chair in your inner room, then it can absorb the sound and we are not be able to hear the sound. Are you getting? We will not get a re-vibration of the sound. Now what is exactly the reflection of the sound? Reflection of the sound is nothing but it is called as an echo. It is called as an echo. In Marathi we say pratidhwani. In Marathi we say pratidhwani. Now see, when you reach any particular mountain and if you will speak so loudly, if you will go on the mountain and if you will shout loudly or you will say hello word, you will get back again that word again. So this is due to the reflection of the sound. That is called as a reflection of the sound. In Marathi we say pratidhwani and in Hindi we say gunj. In Hindi we say gunj. Okay. Now see, but the revibration of the sound we get, the human ear can hear the revibration of the sound between the interval of 1/10 second. What is the interval? 1/10 second. The human being cannot distinguish between the two sounds. If the two sounds are simultaneously spoken or we are not able to distinguish between the two sounds if they have speak togetherly, we cannot distinguish them if the interval is less than 1/10 of the second. So the human being can distinguish two sounds if they have heard after the 1/10 of the second. What is the limit? That is of 1/10 of second. So human being can hear the sound after and distinguish the two sound after the interval of 1/10 of second. Okay, then to get an echo we need the distance between the distance should be of 17 meter. The minimum distance it should be a 17 meter, so we are able to hear the echo. So we can hear an echo. The distance between it should be of 17 meter. The maximum distance it should be, minimum distance should be the 17 meter, so that we can hear the revibration of the sound. That is called as an echo. Okay. Then what is the use of an echo? Can you tell me what will be the use of an echo? Yes, there is a great use of the echo is that we can use this echo to calculate the depth of the sea, locate underwater object, to see the hidden iceberg in the sea. Are you getting? These are the uses of the echo. Now how we can use? See, there is one system that is called as a sonar. Now what is exactly the sonar? Sound, navigation and ranging. What is the full form of sonar? Sound, navigation and ranging. The full form of sonar is sound, navigation and ranging. Now what is this that we will see? Now suppose this is a ship. Okay, this is a ship. On this ship there are the at the bottom of the ship there are the two devices. They are fitted. There are how many devices? Two devices, which when the ship is, okay, suppose this is a sea, okay, and on that ship, under that ship, at the bottom of the ship, there are the two devices. The one device is called transmitter and another is called as a receiver. This is called as a transmitter. How it works? Now here we are going to see how it works, how the echo is used to calculate the underwater depth, that we are going to see. On the ship, at the bottom of the ship, there are the two devices are fitted. That is, one device is called as a transmitter and another is called as a receiver. Okay, another is called as a receiver. Okay, now if suppose here is suppose any fish is there that we have to see. Okay, underwater object if we want to see, or we have to calculate the, suppose what is the depth of this sea. What is the depth of the sea if we want to calculate, then how we can calculate? See, this is a transmitter. Transmitter means it gives the ultrasonic sound. It transfers the ultrasonic sound. The ultrasonic waves are moved to the downward, and as it moves to the downward, it reaches to the particular distance at the bottom of it, and they are received by this ultrasonic. These waves are transmitted and get reflected by this receiver. The receiver receives that ultrasonic waves. The transmitter transmits. The transmitter transmits the ultrasonic waves, and these are received by the receiver. After transmitter, when transmit the ultrasonic wave, it get reflected after the at a particular distance. When it reaches at particular bottom, these are reflected by the receiver. Then the ultrasonic waves after the receiver, they are taken on the computer or on the screen, and we can calculate the depth of the sea. We can calculate the depth of the speed. Now see how we can calculate. Now what is the formula for the speed? Speed is nothing but distance upon time. Distance upon time. Now we can get, now see, as soon as the transmitter transmit the ultrasonic waves, we can start the stopwatch or the particular time. Yes or no? So we can get the time. The distance, see, once it is going down and it is coming up, we can get the total distance. This is 1 and this is 2, am I right? So we will get the distance, yes or no? So distance should be divided by 2, because we have to calculate only single distance, am I right? This is, here you will get on the screen double the distance, because see, the same distance it is traveled down and again it is reached upward, am I right? So divided by 2, are you getting? So like that we can calculate the speed of the of that particular boat. Are you getting this? Or the ship, are you getting? So this is how the echo is used in the calculating the depth of the underwater, depth of the sea. So what will be the what is the full form of sonar? Sonar is nothing but sound, navigation and ranging. It is used to calculate the depth of the sea. It is also used to calculate the hidden object under the water. So this we can use the, for this we use the concept of echo. We use the concept of echo. Are you getting this? In today's video, we have seen about the reflection of the sound. Reflection means bouncing back the sound. Means we are getting the back the sound, that is called as a reflection. We have also seen about a good and bad reflector of the sound. Good reflector means what? Which can gives a good quality of an echo. Then echo, the human being can distinguish between the two sound after the interval of 1/10 of the second, and the minimum distance required to get an echo is 17 meter. Then the use of, what is the use of the echo? Echo is used to calculate the depth of the sea. It is also calculate the underwater hidden object or the hidden icebergs. Then we have seen the concept of sonar, that is, what is the full form of sonar? Sound, navigation and ranging. How it is used? On a ship, there they have put it two at the bottom of the ship. There are the two instruments, two devices are fitted, that is, one is called transmitter and another is called receiver. When the transmitter transmits the ultrasonic waves, it goes to the particular bottom of that sea, reaches the bottom, and as it reaches the bottom, it reflects back. It reflects back, and it is received by the receiver, and with the signal of this receiver, the receiver On the screen, the ultrasonic waves are converted into electrical signal and we can get the hidden object on the screen. I hope you have understood this video. So go through this video and remove the notes of it. Thank you.